I don't know with you guys, but I always enjoyed reading the 64-page flipside comics of the Ultraverse. Let's take a look here. First, we got mantra number 10. But you flip it. Then you have Ultraverse premiere number 2. Very interesting concept. Now take a look at that. Look at Mantra. Look at Elvin, Ripfire, Warstrike, the varied writers and artists, and all the other important people who made these stories come true. Very good. Now you try to reach the half. Oh, and that's a nice pin up there. Warstrike. Let's see. The solutions. Or rather, the solution, sorry. How I miss looking at the ads like these with the Ultraverse. Definitely, the Ultraverse was one of the coolest line of comics back in the days. Of course, mantra number 10. Yep. That's Mantra or Eden Blake. Great concept here. Mantra was hot. No doubt about that. Let's check the other one. Strangers number 13. Ultraverse premiere number 4. Mortal Kombat. Now that's Mantra in a different costume. You really have to read the Mantra comics to find out why she appeared like that. Ask Diane. Oh, this is cool. Hard case. The story of Lady Killer. And then, of course, you have Prime. Ultraverse premiere often featured multiple stories featuring different characters, different situations, and of course, you also get to see the talent of the people involved. You got solid writers like Lance Rzewski, Gerard Jones. Then you got the artists like George Perez and many others who made the Ultraverse one of the best superhero lines of comics I ever read. The Ultraverse still matters to me until now.